Hi everyone, Chef from Outdoors in the Low Countries. Now, as you could see in the other videos, I'm doing some landscaping here in the Low Countries. Part of that is also this small piece of forest. Now, it's a nice forest, it has a lot of trees, especially the oak and the birch cherry are the trees that you see here. I like to create some more variety, I like to create some more color, some more flourishing, and that's why I decided to create a forest garden. So that's why I bought quite some half shadow plants. I will put them here in the forest at some locations. I will show you how I did that in this video. I will also show you what they are. It's also new for me, so I'm also very curious how it will develop. We'll see. So the first plants that I will put will be in this area. So what do I have? I have here an orchid, a Plione, which is of course a very beautiful plant, and I'm very curious how it will develop. Then I will put in this begonia, it's a very nice colorful plant. Of course, a few hostas, two different types. Hostas I do have all over the garden at the various types and borders. I really like hostas. Also I'll put in a Kniphofa flamenco. It's the fire arrow plant, as they call it. So first I will make a hole with the spade, then putting some potting soil to give them a good start, and then cover it up with some chips from the wood chipper. That's also for me easier to find them back, because they're quite small plants. And then I hope that they will develop themselves. We'll see. So the first plants are in the ground. I hope they will do fine. We'll see. I put in some chips in order to have the moisture in, but also to protect them from weed and other stuff trying to take over, like ivy. So I need to help them now and then, I think. I really hope that they will really flourish. But that's something that we have to wait for, to see how that develops. Now here on this spot, I intend to have three plants. This is really my favorite, the Erysimum, the Bowles Mauvre. I already have it at the border in the field. It comes quite large and it's already a little bit woody. It's a very nice plant and it's doing well. I hope it also will do very well here. Then I will have a pink Anemone. And a very nice red Lupinus. So near this natural drinking spot that has been formed by an American oak, I will also put some other plants. So a shadow plant par excellence, the fern. This one is the, let me see correctly, Polypedium vulgare. In Dutch that means that it's a dirty plant, but I think in Latin it means something different. Then also the Chelone Oblica, also a half shadow plant, very nice pink flowers. I will also again put in the Kniphofa flamenco. This one I'm very curious how that will do, is the Anopalis, also known as the Siberian Edelweiss. And I will also put in a hosta in this place, because I like to have it in the middle and like grow it out.
some animal has dug up my orchid. It was doing quite well. I'm not sure what animal it is. Let's hope it keeps away from it now.
As you can see, some of the plants are doing already quite well. Some are being eaten, some are being dug up. That's also why I put in the tag, so I know when some plant is missing. It's really an outdoor forest garden. We'll see how it will develop, and I will keep you updated. Thanks for watching. See you next time.